Yeah, plenty of playoff action at the weekend. Some big, big games. Let's catch up. Here's the Moose for the Roundup.
Preston will find out who they'll play in the League One playoff final at Wembley tonight when Swindon and Sheffield United meet at the County Ground. Swindon with a 2-1 lead from the first leg. Preston made it to Wembley with a 3-0 win yesterday over Chesterfield. 4-0 on aggregate, one for Joe Garner and two for Jermaine Beckford. So what a difference a week makes for manager Simon Grayson.
7 days ago when we obviously missed out on the automatic promotion, we were very low, but a week in football is a short time at times, and we're feeling a lot better tonight than we did last.
Right, talking of playoffs, listen, it's not a nice way to lose a game. But of course, Preston going through to the final. But there was more drama. Chesterfield captain Ian Evatt said he was punched, kicked and spat on the pitch by rival fans after the League One club's defeat at Preston. Ian's now live on the Sports Breakfast. Ian, a very good morning. Hi, Ian.
Morning.
Ian, how are you now? Just tell us what happened. Explain what happened for people just joining us.
Well, basically, obviously, there was a pitch invasion after the game. Yeah. Myself, being an ex-Blackpool player, was probably targeted by Preston fans, to which must have been a couple of hundred of them. And then I was hit a couple of times in the head.
What, punched?
Punched, yeah, and kicked, spat at, and verbally abused.
Shocking.
You know, and it wasn't nice, to be honest. It wasn't nice to have to deal with it, especially because, you know, the referee blew the whistle when we were at the wrong end of the pitch, so I had no way of getting off the pitch. So yeah, there was no way of me avoiding it, really.
Oh, dear. And Ian, just over the both games, you played well first, the first game, I believe, didn't you? You played a little bit unlucky, Chesterfield?
Yeah, I think, credit to Preston. They were probably the better team over the two legs, but we gave a good account of ourselves. We just probably didn't have the cutting edge we needed to win the games, but good luck to them in the final. You know, I've got no hard feelings towards the players and management staff at Preston.
No.
They've done very well this season, and I hope they go on to do well at Wembley.
So, Ian, what can we do about these idiots, right? You know, I know some people, once they get on a pitch, they get a bit overexcited, but this is clearly more than that. Can we catch them? Have you got video, maybe someone with a phone or anything? Have you got any proof at all?
Yeah, well, lucky for me, obviously the police were down after the game. Lucky for me, Sky Sports were obviously televising the game, so they came down straight away with the footage of the two guys that threw the punches. So it's clear as day. So hopefully they'll get their comeuppance and they'll be banned from football.
Yeah, absolutely. And Danny was talking about, Danny Murphy alongside me, was saying we've got to stop this, it's ridiculous.
Well, I was just saying that, you know, I mean, I don't know how you must have felt there, how scared you were or intimidated you were, but unfortunately, even though a lot of the people on there are for right reason trying to celebrate something good, the minority spoil it for everyone else and make you feel however you felt. You know, you must have been scared.
I was terrified. I mean, I'm a big guy, you know, and the
lads thought that.
In the changing rooms after the game, I was, you know, distraught because I've never been faced with such, you know, anger, and it was scary, especially being on my own. All the teammates had been shepherded off the pitch. I was literally on my own with one other teammate, so it was hard for me. But how long is it going to go on before a player gets seriously injured? This is the question.
That's,
you know, all it takes is one idiot with a knife or whatever else, and it's going to happen one day, whether we like it or not, until something's done about it.
What should be done, Ian? Because my problem is, as much as a steward would like to help, they can't. If they're outnumbered and outpowered, how can they help, you know?
Exactly. I think the only way that people are going to learn is if the clubs get punished. I mean, obviously, I don't want that as a player, but how else are the fans going to learn not to go on the pitch? I just can't. I mean, we can't bring back the cages, can we? You know,
No.
So there's got to be some other way around it, and maybe it's that time for the FA to stand up and start punishing people.
Well,
I think,
Ian, for the bigger games, you know, we can maybe, the clubs have to fund for more policing or more stewards, Al. You know, they know it was a big game. They know someone's going to be celebrating or commiserating. Also, I mean, in some European leagues as well, do you see some of the stadiums, it's that really kind of, the netting. It's very hard to see, and they put that up, don't they, to stop the fans?
Yeah, that could definitely help. I mean, from my point of view, I mean, I don't like criticising referees, but yesterday, I mean, all game I was getting abused, so it was plain to see what was going to happen. And he's he's waited the performance. The game was over pretty much, so he's waited till the ball was at the wrong end of the pitch and then blew up. He could have helped me a bit more and probably helped my teammates with a, you know, giving it a few more seconds till the ball was up our end so we could get down the tunnel. But
yeah, but Ian, I suppose with the score the way it was, we can't expect referees to have to make decision based on.
No, of course, Danny. Yeah. I'm just speaking about my own personal situation.
Yeah, your own
situation.
Personal situation. Yeah.
What about Ian? What about your manager? Was Paul anywhere near you? Was he close by? Did he try to get some help to you?
No, because they'd all been shepherded down the tunnel because obviously the fans were waiting around the pitch. So our staff, our substitutes, were all already down the tunnel. It was literally just the players left on the pitch.
Ian, can I just ask you quickly, did you end up having to fight back to not survive as such, but to get through it, to get back to the safety of the tunnel?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'd never throw a punch at any supporters or anything like that. I'm not that kind of person. But, you know, yeah, I was having to, you know, use my body weight and strength to fight my way out of the hole, really, because at one stage I was right in the centre of the pitch, and you know where the tunnel is at Deepdale, it's miles away, so it was difficult. But luckily for me, one teammate managed to find me and help me out.
Good, Ian. Sorry about that, mate. Let's hope we catch them, eh?
Yeah, let's hope so. Thanks
Fingers
very much,
crossed.
Guys. Thanks for
thanks
having
for
me on.
Thank you.
On.
Well done, Ian Everett. There, you know, listen, it's not just a little. If someone's really going to try and give you a dig. You know, and you're in the middle of surrounded by people. What can you do, Danny? You've got to fight back.
Well, listen. He's so unfortunate to be put in that position because he's just lost the playoff semi-final. You're upset enough.
Yeah.
And the last thing you expect to be dealing with when you're knackered after 90 minutes, as well, is having to fight your way out of trouble.
I don't think there's any trouble at Colchester because Preston were down their last game. They took thousands.
Yeah, when they lost.
But I didn't read any. I didn't read anything about it. But I know there was a big, big Preston support. And of course, it didn't click. He's ex-Blackpool, isn't he?
Yeah, but it just, listen...
Doesn't make it right.
Every team that goes somewhere else is going to have a player who's got history with it. There's always going to be something. How do we stop it is the point.
Mm.
Because it's happening more and more now.
Yeah.
How do we stop it? Now, there's a few ways that we've just talked about. But ultimately, if it doesn't... If the club doesn't sort it out with extra policing or extra shoes...
You'd like that netting up.
I'm not saying, I'm just thinking...
Yeah, you want netting, cages.
No,
you
no,
want fencing,
no,
you want moats.
I won't put you in a cage. Be a big one.
He wants a moat.
No, I'm just thinking of things you could do, but I think in the big games, just pay for... The club has to pay for the extra policing if it's available.
Mm.
Or the stewards. Problem is a lot of stewards are. I don't know how many games you've been to recently, but a lot of stewards, they're fans, aren't they? They're watching the game, not watching the crowd.
Okay, 9:43, back in a tick.